Hey everybody, welcome to Mom Plays. I'm Mom, hello. We are here in beautiful Tranquility Lane. Who's sitting next to me? Oh, hello Janet. No idea somebody was sitting next to me. Okay, so we are playing Fallout 3 and we are in search of our dad. And last episode, if you remember, we ended up in this simulation on Tranquility Lane and we became the pint-sized slasher and did everything that this little girl over here, Betty, wants us to do, which all was evil. Lost lots of karma. I said we weren't gonna play our character that way, because there's two ways to play it. You can either do everything that she wants and be completely evil about it, and escape, or there is a different way. So we are now on to way number two. Hello, Doc. Yes, you're a good doggie. Ah. And if you didn't guess from the end of the last episode, that's our dad. Betty made our dad a dog so he would stop bothering her.
Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun.
We are. And you are?
I'm Betty. I live here on Tranquility Lane. Want to play a game?
Not really. No games for me.
You don't get to say no. If I want to play a game, you're going to play. And I want to.
Okay, look, kid. I'm not interested in playing games.
I said I want to play a game. It's easy. You make Timmy Newsbaum cry, and I'll help you. If you don't, then I guess you're stuck here.
All right, so now we have to make Timmy Newsbaum cry. Now, I think I always make him cry. I think you lose karma, but, you know, whatever. So here's little Timmy again.
Hiya. Hi there. I'm Timmy. Wanna play?
Betty says I should make you cry. Have you seen my dad? What can you tell me about the neighborhood? None of this is real. Blah, 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 blah. How about Betty says I should make you cry?
What? No, she didn't. Did she? I don't like her. She's creepy. And she laughs at stuff that isn't funny.
Okay. I heard your parents are getting a divorce because of you. Should we try to make the speech check? Bye, Timmy.
See you later.
And we will go ahead and save right here so that we can pass the speech check, I guess.
You're a big dumb liar.
All right. Oops, that is not what we wanted. Let's see if we can pass this. Load that game. This is how you pass speech checks when you can't pass speech checks.
You're a big dumb liar.
Damn it. Let's see if we can do this. If not, I'm just gonna punch him in the face.
Hi, wanna play? You're a big dumb liar.
I am telling you, this has gotta work.
Hi, wanna play? You're a big dumb liar.
All right, fine, we're gonna punch the hell out of Timmy just to get this going here. I lost karma, but I only lost it once, so I guess that's okay. We could keep trying to do the speech check, but that would be really boring. I just want to get this moving.
And you said you didn't want to play.
I know I didn't.
I was hoping for more than fisticuffs, but entertainment has been difficult to come by lately. Consider the game won.
Yeah.
And with that, you win a prize. Your prize is one question, which I will answer to the best of my ability.
All right, where's my father?
Your father?
He's a scientist. He's looking for Dr. Braun.
Oh my, what a splendid turn of events. I had no idea the two of you were related. Yes, I have indeed seen him. I'm afraid he's rather unavailable at the moment.
What have you done to him? Yeah, what have you done to him?
Were I you, I'd be more concerned with myself at the moment.
But I'm not.
And besides, we're done with questions for now. Perhaps we'll address it at a later time. First, I have something else for you to do.
All right. No, I'm not doing anything else for you.
Then once again, we find ourselves at an impasse. How disappointing.
Oh, damn it, Betty.
Are we willing to be reasonable now? I ask so very little of you.
I don't really have a choice, do I?
There is always a choice. Sometimes it's just easier to make.
What do you want me to do?
Pay a visit to the Rockwells. They're very happily married, and I'd like you to change that. Put an end to their marriage, and we'll talk.
All right, fine. It's only because I want more answers from you.
Rationalize it any way you'd like. If you succeed, we'll continue our discussion.
All right, so we are not going to put an end to their marriage. We are going to look for Old Lady Dithers.
Good day.
Let's see. I can't remember if she, like, confronts you in here or not. So let's... Hi, Mabel. So let's come in here. Let's grab this, like we did last time.
Hello. Mabel, I meant to ask you, have you seen the new Robco catalog? I thought you might be interested, since you don't seem to like your Mr. Handy. I don't want a new one. I don't even really want the one I have now. I don't trust
it. She doesn't trust her Mr. Handy. That's interesting. Okay, old lady Dithers, you usually come here and tell me not to do bad things. Let's see what happens when we go in the Rockwell. There's the Rockwells.
Hello!
Hello! Hello! He's like Mrs. Doubtfire, not dressed as a lady. Yeah. Ms. Dithers, where are you? Let's see. I hate this part because if she doesn't find you, there she is. If she doesn't find you.
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here.
No, I'm not.
It's not real. None of it. It needs to end. The suffering must end.
Finally, someone who knows what's going on. How do I get out of here?
We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up. Make believe. We're sleeping, dreaming. The dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge. He is. And he doesn't want us to wake up.
Okay, who are you talking about?
He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun. Bastard thinks because he helped create this place, he's God here. But I know he still uses the fail-safe terminal. I know it.
Ah, what failsafe? What the hell are you talking about?
It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside. The only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to find it.
All right. I will have no problem finding it because the abandoned house is somewhere over here. Is it this one? See a doghouse, that's usually a good sign. Yes! So as you can see, we have a house that is definitely more dilapidated than the other ones. Like she said, nobody's allowed to come in here because it is the way out without doing Betty's bidding. So let's see here. Okay, so I forgot we have to do the song. Oh god, I hate this. Okay, so pitcher. Gnome? Pitcher? Nope. Okay. Pitcher? Why do you hate me? Pitcher? Why is it doing that? Do I have to, like, reset it? Pitcher, gnome. Pitcher. Cinder block. I know that the Coke glass, I think, is last, right? Nope. Okay, so here. There we go. Nope. All right, so is that the beginning? Okay. Oh. Nope. Okay, D. Dang it. Nope. Damn it, I hate this. Get this, people, without me looking it up. Is it this one? Ah, finally! Whoo! That didn't take very long, right? I mean, it just took forever. Alright, so we have activated the failsafe terminal. So let's take a peek at this. Activate Vault 112 auxiliary command control or whatever, command terminal. All right, Chinese invasion protocol, version control, and Dr. Bronze entries. Let's look at his entries. The first one is Toucan Lagoon, tired of beating sun and ceaseless pounding of the lagoon's waves upon the shore. I no longer take pleasure in watching Simpson wither away from scurvy or hearing new spawn screams as he's devoured by the Mako shark. I am quite simply bored. It is time to reset the simulation once again. So obviously I haven't been skiing in ages. He's been running many, many simulations. These people have not died. You know, they just are stuck in his purgatory. So he missed skiing, so he went to the slalom chalet. Yesterday, Dither slipped on the chalet's icy stairs, went airborne, and managed to impale herself on the wrought iron fence. It was spectacular and completely and utterly random. Is there anything more sublime than that bold crimson on fresh fallen snow? He's gross. It was almost enough to make me reconsider a change of scenery, but not quite. 23 years is a long enough vacation in the Swiss Alps. I long for something more domestic. Which would be Tranquility Lane. Here we go. I have surprised myself. I find Tranquility Lane comforting. Although distinctly American, it somehow reminds me of Cronach, the town of my childhood. There's a beautiful irony with this particular simulation as well. The residents here are naturally at home, naturally safe. When I toy with them, when their suburban illusion is suddenly broken, it's that much more satisfying. I do believe we all shall all remain here in Tranquility Lane for a very long time. A very long time indeed. So he's a little twisted and deranged. Version control. Okay. All right. Well, that makes no sense to me. But anyway, access Chinese invasion program. So, this is failsafe program documentation, Dr. Braun entry. So let's look at this. Here's the revised code for the military training program you've expressed interest in. I'm not sure exactly what you want with it, and I again stress that this program was never designed to be run with civilian equipment. Frankly, I don't expect the system you have to have access to can even run it. Oh, God. But if you can run this program with the failsafes off, as requested, your real-world test subjects will die if killed in the simulation. It goes without saying that officially I denied your request, General Constantine Chase. So, he shouldn't have this, but he does. All right. Failsafe. There are days I consider finally pulling the plug, as it were, and putting a permanent end to both this simulation and my life. That is the reason I requested installation of General Chase's Chinese invasion program after all. By disabling the safety protocols, I have ensured that each subject in Vault 112 will physically die if their simulation avatars are killed. Real world death, end of simulation, the perfect failsafe. At least it would have been, if not for my own misjudgment. I knew when the simulation first went online that the secondary safeties, those established for all Vault Tech and military personnel, would prevent my own real-world demise in the event of a failsafe execution. In the end, I would kill the subjects and save myself. I wouldn't want it any other way, or so I thought. It's true the failsafe would scare the living hell out of every resident in Tranquility Lane and lead to their brutal deaths, but then, what about me? I have no ability to disable my own safety from within the simulation, and any other avatars I could create would be driven by the simulation's AI routines, not actual living, thinking human subjects. Where's the fun in tormenting a machine? And so, the release of the real-world subjects is more than they deserve. I think that's supposed to be more than I could bear. They'd be dead, and I'd be left here in Tranquility Lane, alone and tragically bored for all eternity. I can think of nothing more unacceptable. So basically, because he can't die, and there's no way for him to get out of the simulation, he's not going to let anybody else die, which means they're stuck there with him. But this is the way that you get out of here without losing a ton of karma. Proceed with caution. So we started the Chinese invasion program, and as you see, we gained karma, basically because we were nice enough to set everybody free. And as you can see, and all this blood down, and it's really loud in my headphones, I gotta tell you. So they are all being given their death and released from this place.
Do you realize what you've done? You've triggered the failsafe, ruined everything. The subjects will die, and I'll be stuck here in this hell alone.
Oh, well.
You ruined everything. Everything.
Okay, it's all over. Now shut up and answer my questions. You'll just reset everything anyway. Who cares? I put those people out of the misery. You're getting exactly what you deserve.
You've taken them all from me. You've left me with nothing.
It's not fair. Nobody to play with ever again.
Yep. Sorry, dude. Alright, so here is Doc. I'm hoping that Doc will leave with us, but I really...
Do you realize what you've done?
Yes, I know. Okay, answer my question.
It is not over. It is not over until I say so.
I just want things to go back the way they were.
Too bad. I came here for the father. My father, now where is he?
He's been right here the whole time. And you were too dense to figure it out.
Not really.
The dog, you see.
Yes, I know.
Man's best friend. But now you've taken all my friends from me.
Okay, tell me about the Gek.
The Garden of Eden creation kit. It was for terraforming. For restoring the world after a nuclear disaster. Unstable technology, and ultimately boring. Why remake the old reality when instead you could create any reality you choose?
Okay, so tell me exactly who you are, who you really are.
My name is Stanislaus Braun. I'm a Vault-Tec scientist. I created this simulation for Vault-Tec, but for myself as well. It was my own design. My own perfection. A better reality than any other. Far greater than my work on the Gek.
Okay, so my father's okay. I can get him back.
Yes, I'm sure he's fine. No doubt, when you leave the simulation, he'll be waiting for you.
But there's no one waiting for me.
Nope. And then I have to go.
Run along now.
Yep, you have fun living in your own created hell for the rest of eternity. And out the door we go. And as you can see, the pod next to us is opening also. And?
You've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. Oh, it's so good to see you, but what are you doing here?
Oh, Liam Neeson, I've tracked you down. I came here to find you.
Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Brawn, or I might have fared better.
Let's see, what, you didn't like being a dog?
Well, I suppose it had its moments. But in the end, I much prefer having opposable thumbs. And now that I'm back, I can get back to work. I need to tell Madison what I've learned.
What did you learn?
I was right about Brawn. The technology he developed is unstable, even dangerous. But it can be adapted for Project Purity. I need to return to Rivet City and talk with Madison. If we can find a Geck, we can make Project Purity work.
All right, so you're going back to Rivet City right now?
Yes. With what I've learned, Madison is sure to see that we can finally succeed where we failed so many years ago. I'd like you to come with me. I'd like you to be there when we finally open the floodgates.
Okay.
That's my girl.
Let's hurry. Now that I know what we need, I want to get back to work as soon as possible.
Sure. Okay. What's the big deal about water anyway? Ooh, we gotta level up. And I have to go.
Be careful, sweetie.
Oh, gosh. Oh, excuse me, guys. Okay, so we need our stake to be so much higher than it is at this point. So I'm just gonna jack that right on up. Yeah. And let's see what we got. Swift Learner, Little Leaguer, Intense Training. Bloody Mess, I do like that one. We don't use pistols that much. I'm gonna take the Scrounger perk, because I almost always take it so I can get more ammo. That's really important. I feel like, as opposed to my other playthroughs, I have not found very much ammo this time. So, or at least not as much as I seem to. So I'm gonna take that perk. The other thing is that we've got doors activated elsewhere, it's hard locked and we cannot get in there, and that makes me upset because I see stim packs and aid kits and I'm sure those lockers are full of good stuff. But apparently we can't get in there. And also, I think the terminal up here is hard locked. And I would really, really like to be able to get in here. Which means I might have to come back. Hello. Yeah, requires a key. Which is probably in that downstairs place. So I guess I'm gonna have to come back here and find out what's in those lockers. Curiosity killed the mom, by the way. I can't just leave that stuff because it's just, I can't. I'm gonna be back to get it. All right, so, oops. So we need to leave here. What's our quest to say? Go to the Rivet City Science Lab. Okay. Can do. Yeah, this way. Not that way. All right, so we will go back to Rivet. Whoa. Dad, you creeped me out there, buddy. Pal, friend. Guy. Oh, apparently I didn't get that. Let's go back to Rivet City. Yeah, we'll go back and we will see what the dealio is with Ms. Lee. And then we will end this episode. So all the way back to Rivet City. Pants exploded, it said on the side there. I don't think I've ever exploded any pants. Why is that closed?
Welcome to Rivet City.
That's weird that that was closed. I don't remember it ever being closed after I come here the first time. That's weird. Got anything to say, Harkness? No? Okay. Let's go to the stairwell. And then science lab. Yes. What we want. Alright, Dr. Lee. Here's my father, who wasn't there a minute ago, but is here now. He is in a hurry.
I told you it would work, Madison. Now I can prove it.
James, you're back.
And with good news. I was right about Braun and the Geck. If we can find one, we can adapt it to work with the purifiers.
I'd like to believe you, James. I really would. This is all just so... so sudden.
Madison, I'm telling you, this is real. I talked to Braun himself. He confirmed it. Don't you see? This is what we've been waiting for.
Yeah.
I don't know, James. So many years have passed. Is it really still worth trying?
How could it not be worth improving the lives of everyone in the Wasteland? What could be a more worthy endeavor?
You haven't lost any of your passion, have you, James?
It's as important to me as ever, Madison. Now it's important to you too. Let's finish it together.
James, we don't have a Geck. I can get a small team together, but we'll need proof that it works before people believe us.
I know, I was thinking about that. The lab at the facility had some old pre-war computers that we scavenged. One of them might be useful.
From the last reports, there's no power at the facility. Even if one of those computers had a database, we couldn't access it.
That's why we're going to head over there right now and get things up and running as best we can.
You know, if it were anyone else asking me to do this, I'd have them run right out of Rivet City.
And you know I wouldn't be here if I didn't think this would really work. It's time, Madison.
Damn you, James. When this is all over, you owe me a drink. I'll get the team together.
Thank you, Madison. It's good to be working with you again. Is everything all right?
Did you need something?
Wow. Okay, now talk to Dad.
We need to get back to Project Purity. The computer there is our best chance to locate a Geck.
Won't that be dangerous?
Probably, but we have to try, don't we? It's too important for the people of the Wasteland to let fear stop us now. We need to get moving right away. Are you coming with us?
Alright, let's get going.
That's my girl.
Damn.
It'll be good to work side by side with you, honey.
You say so. All right, so join the scientists at Project Purity. And we don't have a whole lot of time, and this next part is a little, I think it's a little long, so we are going to end it here, and we will meet Dad at Project Purity in the next episode. You have been watching Mom Plays. You can follow me on Twitter at Tonya Treese. I will catch you in the Wasteland next time.